Hello all, this is Jaames Johnson, a.k.a. Sulphur Blade, and I'm back here with another episode of our Llywelyn, the Great of Aberfraw. It's like the second or third ruler in the Monarch's journey, where we're basically playing as Wales, which I've renamed Camelot, and life is good. I've actually renamed the dynasty to Pendragon. So we need to basically conquer some more land so that we can get three more duchies, and then we will be done with this challenge. Though I am quite enjoying this playthrough, to be honest. I love Welsh playthroughs. I don't know what it is, but I just love this spot of the map. It screams to me enjoyment. There's something about it. Don't know how to describe it, but I've always enjoyed playing in Wales. I suppose we should go try to take Leinster. Do I still have a truce? I've got another year yet, actually, till I can declare that war. Oh, and I'm trying to see the realm prosper, so... I wish it showed when you started the ambition. Go with Uther. A blessed has passed. Charles Pendragon lived a pious life, truly following the example of God. He passed 25 April 1291, and people have long wondered if he would be considered a true Christian or not. A large ceremony is held in Charles' honor by the Pope to celebrate the life he lived, a virtuous exemplar of true Catholic. The Pope will write his name in among the pious Christians of old, a bastion to piety in the life of a stalwart example in death. Blessed be his memory once again in the arms of God. Family member was made a saint. Okay, this is the second family member that's been made a saint, but will it actually show up in the saints? No. What's up with that game? Why are you doing this to me? Ah, I feel cheated. Why am I losing piety by doing this? Well, I guess he has to be baptized by the Pope. As a child's godparent, huh? You know, I feel like the spymaster is the person to go with here. Because, God forbid, if anything happens to me, I want to know that the spymaster has the back of my heir. So, we're going to go Duke Io made a compelling case. Pope Gregorius IX washes the child three times over, reciting a prayer to protect his soul, surrounded by a host of cardinals. Then he raises little Uther up for all the crowd gathered in the great cathedral to see, exposing him to the cheers of his future subjects. What a priceless sight. Right, we're not going to be building anything for a little while as our money builds back up. Well, John, you look like you're a capable steward. We'll go with you. Jordan, sorry. John is the better candidate for the job. A saint in heaven. Are there two different pop-ups here? Because this pop-up came with music, and it says a saint in heaven. Blessed Rogers was a true exemplar of the Christian faith, living a pious and moderate life. In a grand announcement, Pope Gregorius IX has decided to canonize Rogers the Confessor. Many tales are told about the saint and the feats he did in life. The story goes that the man was drowning in York when Saint Roger ran across the water to help the poor drowning man. It was only after the man was safely rescued everyone understood the miracle which had just happened. Following the footsteps of God so literally is only fitting for one as great as Roger. It is a great honor for the family of the blessed saint. May we all aspire to become as pious as him. Blessed be his name. And he shows up. Okay. So, for some of you who might be watching, and you may be wondering just how experienced I am with Crusader Kings 2, because obviously, I'm still learning stuff, right? This game is a game so deep, I don't think you can ever stop learning it. I've got 1,000 hours before getting it on Steam, and with Steam I have over 2,500 hours. So I'm closing in on 4,000 hours in this game. And, yeah. Every time I play, every time I load it up, I'm still learning stuff. Still seeing new events pop up. And that's just, it's just something you have to love about this game. Every playthrough is fresh and different. And I have probably 60 to 70% of those hours have probably been Catholic. And they've probably, you know, half of that percentage has probably been in and around Ireland, Wales, England. And so when you put that much effort into a single focus in the game and yet the game still throws new stuff at your, at your specialty, if you will, in the game, and you still learn new stuff even in your most played areas, it's pretty impressive. County of Dunbar. Well, that's interesting. Free captives. I don't think I've ever done a free captive war. It also helps that they've updated this game so many times, and so every time you kind of restart, they've put in new content. That's where it is. That's part of the Holy Roman Empire. Man, that's terrible! I sort of want to own the county of Gloucester and the county of Hereford. I think that, I don't know, it would make a nice border. But at the same time, those are individual counties within duchies that I wish to remain in English hands, the duchies that is. That it would cause constant malice between me and England, so I can't do it. So there's definitely somebody in my court that's a Lollard. There must be a secret Lollard conspiracy around me. Oh good, Gregarious is back. Oh yeah, I'm a drunkard. I forgot about that. So I want to search my court. Yeah, I just have these three Buddhists. And a Jew. Okay, so it's definitely a secret sect, if you will. How about a simple Gwen? I want to make you my apprentice. And why can't I? Alright, fine. How about Lagirtha then? Money continues to flow through the trade post in Bath, but your relationship with the merchant family that owns it has soured. To teach them a lesson without going to war, you could arrange for a mob to burn it down. Sure. Assemble the mob. She pulled it off that fast. I didn't even get a chance to tell her to stop. Well, well. Policata managed to kill off Ciri. Fighting the good fight down there in Castile. Yeah, shame to attack him now. My truce is over. But I have the realm prospering. Ambition. So I guess I will wait the 5 years. Or that could happen, which will ruin my realm prospering, won't it? Actually, it seems to have not. Destined Steward. Interesting. What happened to my spymaster? He wasn't that old. Two guys no longer. Murdered under the orders of Duke John. Well, I guess that's fitting. A fitting way for a spymaster to die. He was murdered. He should have been better at his job. Could imprison Duke John for it, evidently, yeah? Nah, I'll let it slide. Thank you. County of Ulster. Well, now I have two strong claims. Does have a nice bloodline. She is on the older side. Yeah, go for it. What you did. Oh, you're excommunicated. Merlin with a Y? Yeah, Merlin with a Y. Oh, right here, 1297. We are about a year away. Good. Hey, the university! The university! The university! Garrison is defense, levy is attack. Local tax modifier, though. That's a hard one to pass up. But I am getting a lot of money right now. I think we're gonna go with the watchtower. Now, is that 10% levy size to my... A network of watchtowers and garrisons have been founded across the realm. Feature will cost 462.5 gold to build and 0.92 per month during construction. That sounds like it should increase my levy size across the entirety of the realm, not just here in the province. That sounds pretty big. 10% of my troops. It's like 1,600 free troops. Yeah, I'm going with that. Stinian, huh? No, how about Steven? I need a court tutor. Alright, we're looking for Welsh, we're looking for Diligent, and we're looking for Gregarious, and possibly Brave. Brave, patient. There's Gregarious, only patient though. There's Diligent, but Portuguese. Diligent, Brave, German. I'm going to have to go with Lagurtha. She's got Brave, which is something, I suppose. She's a decent strategist, which is somewhat important. It really would be nice if she was diligent and or gregarious, but we will go with Lagurtha. Commanders. I'm sure Arthur. Alright, that's better. You're not getting Scottish influence anymore. Now what happened to this last spymaster? There we are. Severe injury. Okay. Gonna leave you on defensive spying because there's people in the realm that don't like me. Or my kids. We're both drunkards? Okay. We're two of a kind, evidently. Alright, the realm has prospered. Now we can start beating down some heads. The faithful prepare for war. Really? Back to Thrace. That's all retinue. I need a plain Jane Welsh commander. You're not Welsh. Arthur, you have brave, that's bad. Club-footed, I don't think. Trickster is semi-alright. Temperate. Brave, dammit. Okay, Welsh, charitable, shy, kind, perfect. Mayor, you'll go there. Well, we're looking to have trigger on the right flank as massive longbow volley. Feint is okay. The following tactics can be used by this flank. Generic skirmish, shield wall, feint tactic, and massive longbow volley. Thank you. charge tactic is really bad for me. What? Massive longbow volley over here? No! Switch those around! Right, we need to do some slight reorganizing here. The timing on this crusade is not great. I need a section of the family that's not gonna cause issues. Luke seems like the best bet. He's actually married, right? Yes. Alright, we got a year yet to prepare. Obviously my retinue will not be going. If fact, I might just send vassal levies completely and let my money tick up. I could lose Gregarious, hopefully I won't. Good. Didn't. So I could get the learning without having to worry about becoming a drunk, because I already am. Or try to get temperate? Will temperate get rid of drunkard? I don't know. Huh. Damn it. You know, there's a bit too much on my plate, man. I've got a crusade coming up I'm gonna have to lead. Besides, I've heard you're a little cruel and your sexuality's a little strange. Plus, you know, you got that funny lip I have to look at, so I must decline. Advisor, huh? Should I go with the dull and cynical Galahad? Familial Kinslayer. Ooh, that's not good. The gluttonous and fat Duchess of Poway? Or how about the ambitious, stubborn, and shy Duke Jordan? I think we have to go with the dull, cynical Galahad. Alright, I need to start preparing for the crusade. Yeah. I think that's a pretty good mix. We got almost 10,000 troops, so, you know, it's plenty of manpower, I think. And we're still making a fair amount of money. Because most of it is all from our vassals. I threw in a little bit of my own troops, but that's fine. Now let's get them on the way. Actually, this is a crusade, so I should be leading men. Won't be able to afford it. More important things to spend my money on. A daughter, huh? How about... charity. How much supply is here? No, I want to pull into Frenchport. Okay, I guess I can't. Why am I getting attrition? Attrition from out of supply 1.4, totally monthly attrition, total troops in county. Next monthly attrition in county. 10 days of attrition. Who are these guys? Why are they even... What? I would have never made this guy a commander. Evidently I have, which seems strange. Uh-oh, double duke. That's not what I want to see. Oh, you're double duke if via marriage. Okay, so that's good. That's fine. But their kids will cause a problem. if they have kids. He is heir to the duchy. Both duchies. Damn it. Mongol Empire. Uh-oh. I didn't realize the Mongols arrived. Just gonna siege down this capital holding. I don't necessarily want to win the crusade. I just want a place, you know, up towards the top. Second would be perfect, actually. Alright, let's go smash some heads. Now there's got to be a big army stack around here somewhere. Oh geez, Black Death. God, no, I'm... Christ. Please live through this duel. Wait, I'm just not gonna choose a focus right now. What? You're all the way over in India? What's a Muslim doing in India? How fast is the Black Death spreading? Well, it's at least not in India, I suppose. That's something. Well, things are turning sour in this crusade. Nobody followed me. Damn it. I think my entire army's destroyed. It is. Siege of what? Oh. Yeah, they're re-sieging this. Wait, what? I'm not there. I left. I swear I left. At court. Yeah, he's back at court. How did he get the plague? Damn it, he brought the plague to court. Actually, get the hospital up! Give us that disease resistance. Fighting a war in the middle of the plague. I mean, who's at the biggest disadvantage here? The Muslims? Or us? Maybe the plague can help us turn this around. I'm certainly not going back there, though. Whatever score I've gotten is what I got. Wait, what's going on back here? Oh, I'm a prisoner. It's interesting that I'm currently in prison where the Black Death is not. So maybe this is a benefit for me? Meanwhile, there's a huge civil war going where my dukes are trying to kill each other, and I can't do a damn thing about it. Arthur, you don't have the plague anymore. Congratulations, you're the new marshal. How about an Eric? My retinue is gonna go visit Iceland. We're sinking some money into the hospital now. Nothing like the Black Death to scare you into hospital panic mode. I think we managed to end up winning this because of the Black Death. I think the Black Death pretty much wiped out the Muslim troops. And because the Europeans were able to bring in fresh troops from outside of the plague, they were able to outlast. Yeah, okay. It has touched my lands. Cornwall is ravaged. The war's over. End it. Give me my second place trophy. Oh boy, that's close. That's really close. How many John Plantagenets are there? Oh, Joan this time. Okay. Saintly skull, huh? Cool. This has a sword added to the treasury. A good chunk of change. Oh, it went out to the island and skipped Ruse. We're gonna go with a hunting focus. Lord and Abydos. Shut the gates! Go home and die in the Black Death. Just give me a little money first. Is that silly war over? What happened? Not in seclusion. I'm not coming out of seclusion to tell you to quit your war. Besides, I don't think your war is going very far right now. How's my retinue doing over here? Looks like they're doing alright. When indeed will it end? Have to do something about that after the plague. Bring out your dead. I've gained a friend. Ah! My wife has become my friend. How nice. Actually, she's stressed. Let's do something about that. Why can't I do something about that? I don't have the esoteric knowledge. I just ranked up, that's right. Although she's 49, probably not worth wasting it on her. Wish I had the ability to rank up construction. Well, crap. Does that mean I have no... You can be the new doctor. Would you mind maybe converting? Oh shit. Because he converted, he lost his learning. Right? Yep. Okay, that was dumb. Oh well. Live and learn. What is going on here? Con Wangathon of England? A Conet of England? What weird crap is going on? King Bjorn of Norway? Really? Oh, he's a Welsh king. Excellent. Brings some culture to Scandinavia. Whatever. Kill the cats. I'm busy, locked in my castle. That was pretty quick. Food set to 5. Couldn't have waited a little bit longer. It's starting to subside. Meat's back on the menu. We just ate ourselves one of the last of a famous bloodline. And Elizabeth. Let me get this straight. Palicata the Gentle is sneaking around at 68 years old with Ragnar, the 21-year-old. Okay, sure, right. Goodbye, Brave. If Arthur says it's a bandit, it's a bandit. Go away, Black Death, go away! I cast you off the island. Black Death is vanishing to give way to the slow fever. Open the gate! Send for our retinue. Ireland, huh? That's interesting. Thrace has turned into Ireland. Do I liberate England, or do I take Ulster? I think I take Ulster. Actually, I think I take Ulster in the next episode. So let's go ahead and wrap this up. We have just gotten through the Black Death. The plague has come through and has wiped most everything out. We took part in a crusade to regain Thrace once again. We took second place and got ourselves some artifacts we still haven't looked at yet. The Imperial Diadem, quality 5. The Byzantine Imperial Insignia, a crown only fit for the true heirs of Rome. Original owner, Duke, says the cruel. Some artifacts have conditions that must be fulfilled before granting the holder the effect. Activation. Government is feudal. Is Basilius of the Byzantine Empire. Interesting. I have... How did I get that? Okay, I got a ruby scepter. Welsh Crusader Falcon. Light infantry, heavy infantry, monthly prestige. Can only have one weapon equipped, evidently. And I have this Warhammer currently equipped. That's light cavalry, heavy foot, plus one marshal. And this is plus one marshal, light infantry, heavy foot. I think this is a better fit for Welsh, to be honest. So we're gonna make that work. Skull of St. Paul of Tarsus. Monthly piety, same religion opinion is active. So we now have a couple of extra thingamabobbers here. And one is really amazing. Plus 4 stewardship? The Byzantine Imperial Insignia, a crown only fit for the true heirs of Rome, is Basilius of Byzantine Empire. That's something I'm never gonna be. You're kidding me.
Okay, so I can't give that artifact to the Basileus. But yet, I have this artifact. Weird. Can I give it to the Pope? No. Okay, so now I have an artifact that just is no use for me. Anyway, so yeah, that's where we are. We won a crusade. We managed to get through the Black Death. We currently have an English neighbor who is all Orthodox and stuff. We have a special liberate Cassus Belli against him that I'm not sure if I want to use, because I of course have my claim on Ulster, which seems more sensible because it'll actually get us a step closer to being to getting another duchy. But you know, this is a special Cassus Belli that I'm not gonna really have access to again, right? And wouldn't that be a very nice, what's the word I'm looking for? A nice tributary state, there's no doubt about it. Very strange what's happening there. Yeah. Anyway, again, I'm Jaames Johnson, a.k.a. Softly. This is my content. Hopefully you're enjoying it. If so, please leave a like and subscribe, and until the next time, all peace.